Have you ever wondered how global companies manage thousands of materials, from raw components to finished goods, while dealing with dozens of suppliers, warehouses, and purchase documents? Welcome to the world of SAP MM, short for Materials Management. SAP MM is one of the most essential modules in SAP ERP, and it plays a critical role in making sure the right material is available at the right place, at the right time, and at the right price, every single day. In this video, we're going to walk you through everything a beginner needs to understand. SAP MM, what it is and why it matters, what core components it includes, how it connects with the bigger SAP ecosystem, how it powers the entire Procure-to-Pay, P2P process, and what a career in MM looks like. We'll cover concepts in simple language, with real-world examples. No SAP screen is required to grasp the fundamentals. If you're someone who's just starting out with SAP or transitioning from a different background, like logistics, supply chain, finance, or procurement, you're in the right place. By the end of this video, you'll have a clear foundation of how SAP MM works and what role it plays in business processes. Let's get started. Section 1. Understanding SAP MM. So, what exactly is SAP MM? SAP MM stands for Materials Management, and it is a core functional module in SAP ERP that deals with procurement, inventory, and material valuation. This module helps organizations handle the logistics of purchasing raw materials and services, managing inventory at warehouse or plant level, handling vendor relationships and pricing, verifying invoices before payment. Think of SAP MM as the engine of procurement and stock movement in a company. Integration with other modules. SAP MM doesn't work in isolation. It integrates tightly with several other key SAP modules. FI, financial accounting. For invoice posting, price differences, and GRIR clearing. CO, controlling. For tracking procurement costs and budgeting. SD, sales and distribution. For linking inbound and outbound logistics. PP, production planning. For raw material availability and stock reservations. WM, warehouse management. For bin level inventory handling. Together, these modules form a seamless, interconnected supply chain process inside SAP. Business impact of SAP. SAP MM ensures that all materials, whether it's bolts, packaging, chemicals, or finished goods, are ordered from approved vendors, delivered on time, stored correctly, used efficiently, and tracked accurately. A breakdown in MM can lead to stockouts, production delays, or even financial losses. In today's competitive world, having a robust MM system helps companies control costs, meet demand, and make smart decisions with real-time data. Section 2. Key components of SAP MM. SAP MM is made up of several interconnected components. Understanding each of them is essential to understanding how the module functions as a whole. 1. Master data. Master data in SAP MM includes the core information used throughout the module. These are not transactional but are referenced in every transaction. Material master describes every product or service a company procures, stores, or sells. It contains details like unit of measure, material type, valuation class, and MRP settings. Vendor master contains all the information about external suppliers, such as address, bank details, payment terms, and purchasing data. Purchasing info record links material and vendor data together, storing data like last purchase price, delivery times, and standard conditions. 2. Purchasing. This component manages procurement activities, purchase requisition, PR, internal request to purchase materials or services, request for quotation, RFQ, Sent to vendors to request pricing and terms. Purchase order, PO. Legal document sent to vendors confirming purchase terms. Contracts and scheduling agreements. Long-term agreements used for repeated procurement. 3. Inventory management. Here's where the material physically moves. Goods receipt, GR. When goods arrive at your warehouse or plant. Goods issue, GI. When goods are sent out for production or sales. Transfer posting, internal movements or changes in stock status. Movement types. Define each transaction type, e.g. 101 for GR, 201 for GI. 4th, invoice verification. This connects MM to FI, ensures that the invoice received matches the PO and the GR. If there's a mismatch, the system flags it for correction. Once verified, it's posted to accounting for payment processing. Each of these components supports the overall procurement cycle in a highly structured and traceable way. Section 3, the Procure-to-Pay, P2P, process. Let's walk through the Procure-to-Pay process from start to finish. 1. A department identifies a need, creates a PR, ME51N. 2. PR is approved and converted into a PO, ME21N. 3. Vendor delivers goods. Warehouse records, GR, MIGO. 4. Accounts receive an invoice. MM performs three-way match, MIRO, 5. Payment is released via FI module, F110. This process ensures control, transparency, and integration between procurement, inventory, and finance. P2P is at the heart of MM. Whether you're buying pens or jet engines, this flow remains the same. Section 4, real-life examples and use cases. Let's look at a few practical examples. 1. Manufacturing company. A car manufacturer like Toyota needs thousands of parts. Using SAP MM, it automates vendor selection, scheduling agreements, and inventory planning, all ensuring production runs without delay. 2. Service procurement. A company hires cleaning services for its offices. SAP MM can handle service PRs, acceptance of services instead of goods receipt, and invoice verification, all tracked. 3. Emergency procurement. A factory machine breaks. MM allows for urgent PR and spot PO creation to procure parts immediately, minimizing downtime. These scenarios show the flexibility and depth of MM in supporting diverse industries and needs. Section 5. SAP MM Master Data. Deep dive. Let's go deeper into master data. Material types. Differentiates how materials are used, e.g. raw materials, finished goods, packing material. Material groups. Logical grouping for reporting and sourcing. Vendor account groups. Control vendor number range, mandatory fields. Number ranges. Helps avoid duplication in master records. Organizational levels. Each data type is tied to levels, e.g., plant, storage location, purchasing org, which define how data is stored and used. Master data is like the DNA of the system. If it's wrong, everything that follows is broken. Section 6. Common challenges in SAP MM. Even with great systems, issues occur. Duplicate vendor or material entries, incorrect movement types during GR or GI, mismatches between PO, GR, and invoice, integration gaps between MM and FISD, data inconsistency in master records. These lead to blocked invoices, stock errors, and reporting issues. Solution: regular audits, master data governance, and well-trained users. Section 7. Career in SAP MM. Thinking of becoming an SAP MM consultant? Here's what you should know. Roles. SAP MM Consultant. Procurement Process Analyst. Supply Chain Functional Analyst. P2P Lead Skills. Procurement Process Knowledge. SAP Navigation and Configuration. Communication and Problem Solving Certifications. SAP Certified Application Associate. procurement with SAP S4, HANA, offered on learning.sap.com, and SAP Learning Hub salaries, 2025 estimates, US $65,000 to $120,000, UK EU, €50,000 to €100,000, India, 8 lakh rupees to 180 lakh rupees, 20 lakh rupees, remote freelance, $40 to $80 per hour. Demand is growing. Million manager roles are in nearly every SAP project globally. Section 8. Getting hands-on experience. You don't need access to real systems to get started. Use free public demo systems. Try OpenSAP simulation exercises. Practice P2P cycles on paper or with mock tools. Join SAP forums and case study discussions. Watch YouTube tutorials and follow along with your notes. Experience builds understanding faster than theory alone. Section 9. Summary and next steps. Let's recap. SAP MM is a powerful logistics module. It includes master data, purchasing, inventory, and invoice verification. P2P is the core process flow. Real-world use cases prove its value. Strong master data is critical. Careers in MM are in high demand. Next, watch the next video on SAP MM master data in depth. Download our free SAP beginner guide. Subscribe for the full SAP MM video series. Thank you for joining this SAP MM beginner session. Your SAP journey starts now. I am Mustafa Kaya. See you in the next video.